Hi and hello. Welcome to the place where you learn the Bible. It's again a joy to meet you through this short meditation. I hope you know what this shirt means. I think this is a very old jersey of the Chelsea Football Club. Since I was introduced to football when I was in my school days, though India is a cricket mad country, though I love also watching cricket, I never miss any Chelsea game. Chelsea, I think apart from meditating the Bible and preparing sermons, in all my free time, if there is one thing that I really love to do is to watch Chelsea matches, is to hear pundits talk about the Chelsea Football Club. You know, you may call me crazy, but I've always been a hardcore fan of Chelsea Football Club. And the past season and the present one has been really good for Chelsea. There are times where, you may wonder, you know, whether this is a sports channel. No, this is not a sports channel. This is a Bible channel. But I'm trying to tell some truth using football as an illustration. So you will get the message in a few minutes. So basically, the thing that I want to say is that I'm a hardcore Chelsea fan. But today, I'm going to speak about another football club. The past two seasons have been brilliant for Chelsea. We won the UEFA Champions League, we won the Super Cup, and now we are in contention even to win the Premier League. Though there are many nervous times, but still it's been a great time for Chelsea this season and even in the past seasons. But since the start of this particular season of English Premier League, there is one team which is considered to be an elite team of England. You know, they are the chief rivals of Chelsea Football Club. If Chelsea are from West London, Arsenal are from North London. So it's the rivalry in London between Arsenal and Chelsea is a lot. But this particular season, after the end of the first month of the Premier League, Arsenal are at the end of the table. They are at the end of the table. They played three games, lost all three, and they haven't scored a single goal yet. And in the previous match, in the last match that Arsenal faced Manchester City, Arsenal lost 0-5 to Manchester City. And at the end of the match, I came across this superb video where Arsenal fans were singing in the stadium, and this is what they sang. They said, they were singing, I will play this video for you. If you didn't understand the words, this is what they sang. We lose every week. You are nothing special. We lose every week. Arsenal fans singing to Manchester City, singing to the team Manchester City, singing to the fans of Manchester City like this. We lose every week. You are nothing special. We lose every week. Now, it might seem funny, but many times we lose again and again in our life that we are happy with losing. You know, today I want to talk to you about a man from the Bible. He kept on losing. His life was filled with failures. But he was the opposite of an Arsenal fan. Arsenal fans said, we lose every week. You are nothing special. We lose every week. You know, the song, the phrase seems as though they are happy to be at the bottom of the table. But in 1 Chronicles chapter 4 and verse 9, it talks about a man called Jabez. It says like this, the New Living Translation says like this, there was a man named Jabez who was more honorable than any of his brothers. Now it's the most important point. It says, his mother named him Jabez because his birth had been so painful. You know, we do not know what kind of pain he caused his mother. Was it just physical pain? Or was it an emotional and mental pain? Did that mother have to go through such a hell that she called her son, you are a pain to me? You know, I remember my sister, my younger sister, When she was giving birth to her child, she went through a lot of pain. She had lots of physical pain. She went through a lot of mental trauma. She was literally going through hell. Everything seemed against her. But even in all that pain, when her son was born, she called him Barnabas. Meaning, she said, maybe someday, one day when my son grows up, he will be a son of encouragement. He will be an encouragement to me. Though my sister had to go through hell during her pregnancy, she named her son Barnabas, saying, he will be an encouragement to me. But Jabez's mother was different. I would use the word cruel. She was cruel to him. That she called him, you are a pain to me. Jabez means pain. You are a pain to me. Every time when Jabez grew up, he was called as, hey pain, come here. Hey pain, go there. Hey pain, do this. You are a pain, you are a pain, you are a pain. He was constantly called pain. But when Jabez grew up, he did not want to be like an Arsenal fan saying, we lose every week. You are nothing special. I lose every week. No, Jabez did not want to be like that. The verse 10 of 1 Chronicles chapter 4 says like this. Now Jabez called on the Lord God of Israel and said, Lord, bless me, expand my territory. And then he says, please be with me in all that I do. Keep me away from all trouble, evil and pain. His mother called him a pain, but Jabez decided that he is not going to live in pain. So he called on to the Lord and he said, Lord, bless me, expand me, keep me far from evil, trouble and pain. And the verse ends like this. And God granted him as he requested. And God granted him as he requested. Two kinds of people. One is a group like Arsenal fans. We lose every week. You are nothing special. We lose every week. And then there is another group like Jabez who say, no, I'm not going to lose every week. I'm not going to lose in my life. Yes, I am down. Yes, I've been pushed down. Yes, I am at the rock bottom. I am in the deepest pit. But no, I will not stay there. I will arise. I will call unto the Lord. Lord, grant me peace. Lord, keep me far away from evil and all trouble. Lord, restore me. Lord, revive me. Today I'm going to end this meditation with a simple question. Don't be an Arsenal fan. Come on. No, not because I'm a Chelsea fan. I'm not saying you don't be an Arsenal fan. I'm saying you do not be an Arsenal fan. Be like Jabez. You might go through hell, but call into the Lord. Lord, bless me, expand me, keep me far away from evil. Keep me far away from all trouble. Keep me far away from all pain. And the verse will end and history will record about you. And God granted that request. May God speak to us. May God revive us. May God bless us. May God expand us. And may God keep us far from all evil. May God be with you and guide you. Stay blessed. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.